This is the Hub on Hollywood. I'm James. Jamie is on assignment, but we still love movies. Thank you so much for tuning in to this week. On this week's episode, of course, we have casting calls. Also, we are watching the new trailer for a new film written and directed by Charlie Kaufman called I'm Thinking of Ending Things. Also, speaking about ending things, AMC, however, they are saying that they are not ending things. In fact, they say that they've survived the pandemic, and they believe that premium video on demand is going to be the future, the wave of the future, the new industry standard. So we will be getting into that. But first, thank you so much for tuning into this week's episode. If you're watching us on YouTube, please like, please subscribe, join the conversation. If you're watching us on Facebook, please share. Always helps. If you're listening to us on any of the major podcasting streaming services like Apple iTunes, Spotify, iHeartRadio, all the apps, all the major apps out there, streaming services where you get your podcasts, we are there. We are also on social media at Hub on Hollywood. You can find us on Instagram and on Twitter. So thank you so much for tuning in. But first, let's go into those casting calls. We have quite a few, so let's just plow right through it. So first off, Slate Casting. Slate Casting is looking for three actors to be lookalikes in a reenactment for a documentary. This pays $375 for 1 to 3 days of shooting in the Boston region. They're looking for a white woman between 25 and 45 years old with blonde or dirty blonde hair, 5'1" to 5'5". Also looking for two white men, one with dark hair and a beard, the other with long dark hair. Age really isn't specified. However, the shooting is taking place this month, the week of the 24th, and it shoots for 1 to 3 days. Now, since this is a reenactment and part of a documentary, they have included three photos for people that they're trying to have resemble the most to. And so you're being asked to send your current photo of yourself, your phone number, where you live, and your acting resume to slatecastingsubmission@gmail.com. slatecastingsubmission@gmail.com. Also for Slate Casting, this is for a national commercial. Serious cyclists and rowers are needed. This does not require any acting experience. This is open to both union and non-union members and is a paying job, but no real information yet of how much the gig is. But you'll need to send in a current photo of yourself with a description of your experience as a rower or a cyclist, where you live, and if you have an agent. And you should be able to send your information to slatecastingsubmission@gmail.com. You may be able to find out how much the gig is paying as well. Also, Slate Casting, this one is for a commercial looking for an African-American mom with outgoing kids between 2 and 7 years old. This pays $1,500. Now, what should be sent is a current photo of the family, ages of the kids, and what city you live in. That should be sent to slatesouthtape@gmail.com. That is slatesouthtape@gmail.com. Put the family in the subject line, the word family in the subject line. Submissions are due today, so this is a very thin tightrope that you're gonna be walking. Get your submission in today. If you're watching this episode on Friday, you still have some time. Going into Boston Casting. Boston Casting, we're looking for male actors between 45 and 60 years old who have a unique dancing style. This is a non-union job. Shooting takes place on August 20th of this month, of course, and it pays $1,500. You're asked to submit a headshot, resume, contact information, and if possible, video of a unique dancing clip of yourself. You can send that to bostoncastingsubmit@gmail.com. Also, Boston Casting looking for men and women to participate in a new home building and remodeling TV series. They're looking for people between 18 and 28 years old and people currently in an apprenticeship, or anybody who wants to work in that kind of field, building and construction. Send your information to bostoncastingconstruction@gmail.com. Don't have any information on this, but imagine if your home gets remodeled, and I don't know if that's the gig, but might be cool. Last one, this last casting call, also for Slate Casting. This is, they're looking for actors to portray fit joggers, ages 21 to 30 for an upcoming commercial. Actors to portray fit joggers, or you could be a fit jogger. Maybe you could act in this one and you get picked. Auditions will be self-taped and callbacks will be done via Zoom. Send your headshot and your resume to slatecastingsubmission@gmail.com. slatecastingsubmission@gmail.com. go out there. If you fit any of those descriptions, if you know anybody who fits the bill, any families, go ahead, send them a link to this episode, send them the information, and they could be the next Will Smith or the next Keanu Reeves and family. And speaking about things and family, and oh yeah, that might be a good segue. Speaking about families, this new movie looks pretty crazy, about a crazy family. It's called I'm Thinking of Ending Things. The trailer just dropped this week. It's written and directed by Charlie Kaufman, and it's a book adaptation. So according to IMDb, this movie is full of misgivings. A young woman travels with her new boyfriend to his parents' secluded farm. Upon arriving, she comes to question everything she thought she knew about him and herself. This stars Toni Collette, Jesse Plemons, and Jesse Buckley, and here's a trailer.
Jake, my boyfriend.
It's snowing.
Winter is coming in.
We have a real connection, a rare and intense attachment. I've never experienced anything like it. I'm thinking of ending things.
Huh?
What?
Did you say something?
I don't think so.
Weird.
I'm visiting Jake's parents for the first time. He hasn't been my boyfriend for very long.
They really are looking forward to meeting you.
I think of ending things.
Hello? We're here.
Oh, hi.
Oh, it's all wet.
Here they come.
Jake has told us so much about you.
He's told me so much about both of you, too.
And you came anyway?
Jake tells me you're studying quantum psychics.
Physics.
Really?
But there's just something profoundly wrong here.
Are you okay?
Yeah. I think you've ending
something. I am so glad Jake has found someone.
Soon this will all be a distant memory. Who's this?
It's me.
No, it was me.
I tell you, I would misplace my own head if it wasn't screwed onto my own head.
I feel like I was seeing them as they were, seeing them as they will be, seeing them after they're gone. I'm thinking of it.
You can stay here. Excuse me? You don't have to go.
I don't have to go where?
Forward.
People like to think of themselves as points moving through time. But I think it's the opposite. We're stationary. And time passes through us. Blowing like cold wind. Maybe this is how it was always going to end.
I'm Thinking of Ending Things. I'm thinking it's looking like a good movie. It's again Charlie Kaufman, written and directed by him. A critically acclaimed writer and director. He's written Eternal Sunshine of a Spotless Mind, which I just saw this year, and really good. Don't know why it took me so long to get to it, but really good film. Confessions of a Dangerous Mind, Adaptation, and Being John Malkovich are just a couple of things under Charlie Kaufman's belt. One big thing about this film, it's appearing on Netflix on September 4th. Don't even have to leave the home, even if I'm still sure most theaters are still closed or strictly restricted. But yeah, you don't have to worry about that. This one's coming to Netflix on September 4th. I'm Thinking of Ending Things. Now, before we get to our last topic, again, thank you so much for tuning into this week's episode. If you are not following us on Instagram or on Twitter, please do so. You can find us at Hub on Hollywood. You can also subscribe, like, comment on our YouTube channel, Hub on Hollywood. What else are we on? We're on the podcast streaming services. You can listen to us on the go. If you're going to go work out and you want to listen to this beautiful voice of mine talking about random movies, you can listen to us on Spotify, iHeartRadio, or Apple iTunes. Thank you so much for tuning in. Now, lastly, AMC. Is AMC having a comeback? We're hearing good things after months of terrible, terrible updates. For a while, AMC was saying that it was in bankruptcy risk. It was at the verge of shutting down. Things are not looking good for AMC, one of the world's largest, if not the world's largest, movie theater chain. But according to Variety, AMC's boss, AMC's CEO, they're saying that they survived the coronavirus. Now, according to Variety, Adam Aaron, CEO of AMC Theaters, he struck an optimistic note on a call with investors and analysts shortly after the world's largest exhibition chain reported it had lost more than $500 million in its most recent financial quarter. He was saying, "I think we survived the corona crisis, and now we've just got to get back up to running the company really well." Now, one part of running the company very well, that's going to be the hardest part of doing anything during the post-pandemic. We're still in the pandemic, and so there's no post-pandemic yet to try to adapt to. Many movie theaters are still closed. The few that are open, under strict restrictions, a lot more movies are now popping up on drive-in theater setups, pop-ups, and even actual locations that have been set up that way for years. But we haven't been seeing a lot of new things. However, AMC, you may also remember, they struck this deal with Universal Pictures after being angry that Universal released the movies Trolls directly on video on demand. They threatened and they did pull Universal Films from their theaters, only to kind of backtrack and eventually make this deal with Universal, saying after 17 days of theater release and 3 weekends, then the film would be available for streaming on demand, PVOD. And that seemed to be a good compromise, really the only good compromise that AMC could do. It really didn't have much of a bargaining chip after, you know, Universal and all these other movie chains are starting to consider bypassing the theater experience entirely and releasing movies on streaming services, just for the fact that when Trolls came out, it did gangbusters for people at home, stuck at home. They watched the movie, raked in hundreds of millions of dollars, and it showed that, you know what, during the age of pandemic, movie makers, movie studios have all the power, and it's going to be up to these movie chains, including AMC, to buckle and try to come up with a compromise, come up with a deal. But AMC CEO, he says that he believes that PVOD will become the new industry standard. According to Variety, Aaron said PVOD will result in more movies being made. He referred to a private correspondence from a studio executive that read, "Adam, you're going to take heat for this action, but AMC just saved exhibition. Honestly, we were going to greenlight fewer and fewer movies." According to The Hollywood Reporter, it looks like more movies are actually going to be made because they aren't going to be made for the cinematic experience in theaters. And so more movies may be greenlit and just sent directly to Netflix or sent to other streaming services and eventually bypass maybe even the 17-day window that some of these theaters, that AMC has agreed to. So he says this is the future of the industry. Again, I feel like this deal that AMC made with Universal really put all the other movie chains into a tough situation, because again, it made movie theaters or movie studios, movie makers realize that they have all the power, and without them, these movie chains aren't going to do well, because apparently people will still watch the movies just comfortably at home, and that doesn't bode well for the in-person theater experience. But you know, what are your thoughts? Do you think AMC will really survive? Was this all talk for investors and they're really scrambling to try to save as much money or build as much revenue as possible before eventually having to shut down? Is that just the inevitable future of large movie chains like this? Or do you think this is just the part of the evolution and this is the way movies will eventually be, it'll become more commonplace for us to just watch the latest blockbuster at home in our pajamas? I don't know. Let me know what you think. Well, this was The Hub on Hollywood. Thank you so much for tuning in. Tune in next week, and we'll talk about more movies, more updates, maybe some Star Wars news. We'll sprinkle it in there. Get Jamie back on the show. But yeah, thank you so much for watching. For The Hub on Hollywood, I'm James, and I'll see you next week.